Sabadee crap to all my fellow carpenters and video makers out there. Third episode of my Creative Thought series shooting welding videos. I'm learning about close-up welding video shots and I'm testing possible setup solutions. In today's video, I'm going to test different kind of ND glasses specifically designed for my GoPro that I just received from eBay. Before jumping to it, thumbs up please if you like my content, subscribe to my channel and ring the bell for future videos notification. And now, without any further ado, let's to build some and let's to have fun with! Okay guys, Creative Thoughts series shooting welding videos. In past episode of this series I built and tested these two cases that hold my GoPro camera behind different kind of glasses from a welding helmet. Both solutions failed. If you are interested about, web link above my head. First lens that I'm going to test is a variable adjustable 2 to 400 ND filter. It is a 37mm lens that fits my GoPro through an adapter like this. The lens has a thread to fit the adapter. It's a graduated lens, so I can adjust the ND shade turning its ferrule. The ND shades go from 2 to 400 and I'm going to test the darkest one. Three tests between 4 and 300. My dated GoPro is a Hero 3 Plus Black. Doesn't have a monitor, so I used to frame the shot through my tablet and GoPro app. However, as you can see, I'm outside under a car parking roof. I move everything and I'm going to test inside my small laboratory, where I can have a much more light-controlled environment. Okay guys, I'm inside my laboratory and as you can see I have a much more light controlled environment. Through some light sources and a softbox I have a really good light distribution. Indeed the scene is lighted properly. My GoPro has only one setting that I can play with. It's called low light and is an on-off setting that in my camera is always on. The camera is set with a narrow field of view. I begin the first test with ND400, the darkest shade. ND400 is too dark. As you can see, easily understandable cause the purple color, the camera sensor is mainly recording the ultraviolet side of the light emitted by the TIG torch. Let's proceed with the second test and I'm going down adjusting the shade to ND350. The purple color is gone, however I'm far behind from the result that I'm looking for. Colors are much better now, not a lot of noise. Unfortunately my ND filter with a 350 shade can't copy with the torch brightness. I proceed now with the third test and I'm tweaking down my graduated lens to ND300. Let's see what's happened. Nothing seems to work. GoPro can't copy with the torch brightness. The test with the graduated adjustable ND lens is done. I don't think it is worth going with the less dark shade. Before to jump to the final conclusions, let me test please the second ND lens that I bought. I'm ready for the second test with another kind of ND typology lenses designed for the GoPro. The new set of ND lenses come with an adapter that fits the GoPro waterproof case like this. The set comes with 4 square shape lenses, ND2, 4, 8 and 16, and I'm going to test the darkest one, ND16 and ND8. My GoPro is set as it was set before, low light setting on and a narrow field of view. I begin the first test with the ND16 lens. Colors are fine. A little noise that doesn't bother much. Anyway, GoPro can't copy with the torch brightness. It still doesn't work. Second and last test with a ND8 lens. ND8 doesn't work too. Colors are fine. No noise. However, GoPro sensor can't copy with the torch brightness. Bead and paddle can't be seen. Third and final test with the ND4 shade. Then I will call for the end. Also, this last test with a ND4 shade clearly failed. Let's summarize the conclusions. Okay, guys. All the tests were a clear failure. On the contrary, I think that the overall experience was a success, because I learned a lot no matter what. As you begin to know me, I'm here to show you the real myself. The success alongside the failures, cause in both situations there is always something to learn. Out there in YouTube there are very well done videos where we can clearly see all the welding actions in close details, the bead, the liquid paddle, etc. etc. All these videos are shot by welding schools, steel factories, professionals that probably invested in pro equipments. I did research about how to shoot a close-up video of a welding action without professional hardware, and I couldn't find much. That's the reason why I did test by myself without any kind of previous experience. I shoot my videos with a GoPro because the quality is awesome. Most important, GoPro with its waterproof case can deal with a dirty environment as a carpenter laboratory is, I mean an environment full of dust. After weeks, months of exposure to that kind of dust that I'm dealing with, a more sophisticated camera without any protection represented by the waterproof case is going to break for sure. So, probably with a more sophisticated camera with a specific setting as ISO for example, the results will be much better. Indeed, with my hardware, I am unable to shoot close-up welding videos. In conclusion, I don't think that the problem is the ND filter by itself. Especially the number 8 shade gave back a nice color, no noise at all. Dealing with these two parameters, the GoPro sensor did a really nice job. made, the main problem is the camera itself. To be honest, I must underline that I'm talking about a GoPro, an action camera that is not designed for this specific task. I hope that in the future I will be able to repeat the test with a more suited camera with specific setting that can copy with the weld torch brightness. If you have any suggestions, some help, anything to underline, please comment down below. I will reply shortly after. In the meantime, thank you very much for watching.